Life without liberty is like a body without spirit, said Khalil Gibran. How blessed this morning is, where we all have gathered to have an insight into the 60 years of Goa's liberation. A very good morning to all of you on the occasion of Goa at 60, the Directorate of Higher Education, along with the Department of Information and Publicity, Government of Goa, has organized a special talk by Sri Rajendra Kerkar on the topic Goa Through Ages. To begin with, I invite Ms. Bhargavi Pednekar of SYBA to invoke Devi Saraswati with Saraswati Vandana.
शुभ्रवस्त्रानृतां या वीणावरदण्डमण्डितकला या श्वेतपद्मासना या ब्रह्मार्चितशङ्करप्रभृतिभिर्देवैः सदा वन्दिता पातु सरस्वतीशेषजाड्यापहाशुक्लान् ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाम् आद्यां जगद्व्यापिनी वीणापुस्तकधारिणी हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे त्वां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं प्रदां शारदा
Thank you so much, Bhargavi. Albert Einstein said, and I quote, "Freedom in any case is only possible by constantly struggling for it." Unquote. Goa had relentlessly struggled for its liberation from the 451 years of Portuguese subjugation. The 1787 conspiracy of Pintos, revolts by the Ranis between 1755 and 1822, military uprising at Volvoy in 1870, mutiny by armed native sepoys in Marseille in 1871, the civil disobedience by Sri Ram Manohar Lohia and Dr. Julião Menezes on 18 June 1946, and the sacrifice made by the numerous freedom fighters like Sri Mohan Ranade, Sri Ravindra Telekar, Sri Braganza Punha, Sri Purushottam Kakodkar, Sri Lakshmikant Bhemre, the list is endless. All these known and unknown names, all these revolts culminated with Operation Vijay on 19th December 1961, which we all know and celebrate as Goa's Liberation Day. Though Goa is known to be one of the smallest states of our country, but over the ages, the different rulers, like the Bhojas of Chandor, Badami, Chalukyas, Konkan, Mauryas, Rashtrakutas, Vijayanagara rulers, Bahamani, Adil Shahi, and of course the Portuguese rulers. All these different ruling periods have unquestionably made Goa a state of diverse cultural and historical heritage. I request Mr. Vishnu now to play the video, Goa Journey to Freedom. This video is made by the Department of Information and Publicity, Government of Goa.
Okay. जगाच्या नैऋत्य वाटणात बशील एक सुपूर्ण पाचवाचा सोबित नदी. आज जे गोय अफगाणिस्तान या गोयचो महामेरे पावपाचो एक प्रवास असा, संघर्षाचो एक क्रम असा, बलिदानाची एक गाथा असा, एक इतिहास असा जो निर्माण झाला. चला तर इतिहासाची पानं उचलू. दक्षिण गोयात कुशावती न्हंयचे देगे चंद्रपूर ही तांची राजधानी आशिल्ली, जाका आयज आमी चांदोर वा चांद्रा म्हणून वळखतात. त्या उपरांत बदामी चालुक्याचे शासन आशिल्ले. ताणी इसवी सन 578 सावन इसवी सन 753 मेरेन राज्य केले. त्या उपरांत शिलाहार राजांनी हांगा राज्य केले. त्या उपरांत 11व्या शतकाच्या सुरवे सावनच गोंयचे कदंब शासकांचे राज्य आशिल्ले. हो काळ गोंयच्या इतिहासाचो भांगराळो काळ आशिल्लो. आयज चांदोरच्या लागी अशी जायती लोकगीतां आसात जी तांची समृद्धी, नाणी, सुधारित वेपार ते पर्यावरणाचो विनाश आणि अभिशापाच्यो काणयो सांगतात. कदंब शासकांनी तांबडी सुर्ल आणि कुर्डी गावांत महादेव मंदिर बांधले. विजयनगर साम्राज्यान गोंयचेर राज्य स्थापित केले. 1469 मेरेन गोंय विजयनगराचो भाग आशिल्ले. दक्खनच्या महामनी शासनान 1478 वर्सा आक्रमण केले आणि गोंयचेर आपले राज्य सुरू केले. ताणी मांडवी न्हंयच्या देगेर किला ही आपली राजधानी केली. अशेच तरेन आदिलशहान 1498 वर्सा विजापुराचेर आक्रमण केले आणि बहामनी साम्राज्य आपल्या ताब्यात घेतले. 1510 वर्स सैनिकी तुकड्यांसयत पोर्तुगाली जहाज गोंयच्या देगेर पावले. कमांडर आफान्सो डी आल्बुकर्काच्या फुडारपणाखाला ताणी आदिलशहाचेर हल्लो केलो. या हल्ल्यात पोर्तुगीजांक हार खावची पडली. मात कांय काळा उपरांत आफान्सो डी आल्बुकर्कान काळाव्या सहयोगींच्या आदारान परतून गोंयचेर हल्लो केलो. ह्या फावट आल्बुकर्क जिखलो. 25 नोव्हेंबर 1510 दिसा आल्बुकर्कान पोन्न्या गोंयांत प्रवेश केलो आणि त्या सांगाटान फुडल्या 450 वर्सांची काणी बरयली. वांगडा आयिल्ल्या क्रिस्ती मिशनरी धर्मप्रचाराचे काम सुरू केले. नऊ नऊ धर्मप्रचाराचे रुपांतर खर धर्म परिवर्तनात झाले. तळाव्या देवी देवतांची पूजा करपाचे, धर्मिक प्रतिकांचा वापर करपाचे आणि त्यांच्या मूर्ती घरात दवरपाचे बंदी झाली. धर्मिक सुवातो खंडित केले. तळाव्या धर्मिक संस्कृतीक रीती पद्धती आचार व्यवहार करतल्यान शारीरिक यातना देऊक लागले आणि लोकांचे नाका नाका जाल्ले कर लागले. पोर्तुगीजांनी 1510 वर्सा इसवाडी आणि 1543 वर्सा मुरगाव साश्ट आणि बार्देसाचेर ताबो मेळयलो. आयचो मुरगाव 1543 साश्टीचो भाग आशिल्लो. अशे तरेन 1791 मेरेन पोर्तुगीजांनी पुराय गोंयचो ताबो घेतलो. आपले साम्राज्य स्थापित करपाक पोर्तुगीजांक सुमार 280 वर्सां लागली. हो फक्त पारतंत्र्याचो इतिहास न्हय जाल्यार शौर्यपूर्ण संघर्षाची गाथा असा. पोर्तुगीजा आड पहिलो विद्रोह 15 जुलै 1583 दिसा कुंकळे झालो. धर्म परिवर्तना खातीर आयिल्ल्या 5 पाद्र्यांचे थळाव्यांनी पुराय येवजण करून हल्लो केलो आणि तांची हत्या केली. तांचो सूड घेवपाक पोर्तुगीजांनी 15 थळाव्यांक उलोवपाच्या निमतान आपयले आणि दबो दिवन तांची हत्या केली. हे घडणुकेक लागून पुराय वाटा तिडक पातळी. 1664 वर्सा छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांनी आदिलशहाचेर आक्रमण केले. शिवाजी महाराजांनी पेडणे, दिवचल आणि सत्तरी आपल्या स्वराज्या खाला हाडले. पोर्तुगीजांनी खंडित केल्ले सप्तकोटेश्वर मंदिर ताणी नार्वे गावात परतून बांधले. साय न्हंयच्या देगेर बेतूल किल्लोय शिवाजी महाराजांनी बांधलो. 1683 वर्सा संभाजी महाराजांनी पोर्तुगीजांचेर हल्लो केलो. पोर्तुगीज हे केले. संभाजी महाराजांनी कितल्याशाच किल्ल्यांचे कब्जा केलं. त्यांनी मर्दनगड किल्ला बांधलो. 1778 वर्षा पिंटोचे बंड झाले. विटोरिनो फारिया आणि जुझे गोन्साल्विस आणि त्याचे पुनर्पण केले. पोर्तुगीजांनी हे बंड मोड उडवले. 13 डिसेंबर 1788 दिसा 47 पुढाऱ्यांक अटक केली. तातुतल्या कांय जाणांक फाशी झाल्यार कांय जाणांक देशा भायले गेले. 1755 ते 1812 मेरेन राणी समाजान गोरिला युद्धा वरवीं पोर्तुगीजांक नाका करून सोडले. मात शासकांनी प्रत्येक संघर्ष क्रूरपणान चिपकयलो. डोंगराळ वाठार आणि दाट जंगलात सुमार 150 वर्षा मेरेन गोरिला युद्ध चालू आशिले. टिपाजी राणे हांनी नानूस किल्लो आपल्या सशस्त्र संघर्षाचो केंद्र केल्लो. 1934 वर्षा क्रिस्ताव दे ब्रागांज पुण्य भारतात परत आयले. आपल्या 5 वांगड्यांक घेऊन 1928 वर्षा ताणी गोवा काँग्रेस समिती घडयली. गोयच्या सुटके खातीर ताणी सत्याग्रह आणि अहिंसा ही आपली अस्त्रां केली. 1946 वर्षा पोर्तुगीजांनी ई बी पुण्य हांकां अटक करून बनकडीत धरले. 1920 वर्षा पोर्तुगालान कोलोनियल एक्ट संम केलो. ह्या खाला पोर्तुगालच्या खंयच्याय वसाहतीक रॅली बसका आणि हेर खंयच्याय सरकार विरोधी सभांचे आणि वावराचेर बंदी. 1932 वर्षा आंतोनियो दे ओलिवेरा सालाजार पोर्तुगालचे शासक झाले. त्या उपरांत गोंयात दडपशाय आणि अत्याचार तेंगशेर पावले. भयानक सेन्सरशीप लागू केली. लग्नाच्या आमंत्रण पत्रिकावरवी स्वातंत्र्याचो गुप्त संदेश दिनात म्हणून हे पळोवचे खातीर ते पत्रिका लेगीत सेन्सर करपाक लागले. दडपशाय वाढपाक लागली तसो विरोधय वाढलो. 1946 वर्षा डॉक्टर राम मनोहर लोहिया गोयातले लोक भयंकर हुकूमशाहीत जगात हे ताणी पळयले. डॉक्टर लोहिया आणि जुलियन मेनेसिस यांच्या वांगडा मिळून एक सभा घेऊची योजना केली. प्रशासनात डॉक्टर राम मनोहर लोहिया सभेची सुवातेर पावले. मात एका पोलीस अधिकाऱ्यान तांचे पिस्तॉल चोखून धरले आणि तांकां अटक करून वडगांवांत जेलीत घाले. आझाद गोमंतक दळ आणि हेर दळां पोर्तुगीजांचे सशस्त्र हल्ले करताले. प्रभाकर वैद्य हांनी आपल्या सांगातान कुंकळे पोलीस स्थानकाचेर हल्लो केलो. मोहन रागडे हांनी बेकी पोलीस स्थानकाचेर हल्लो केलो. अस्नोडा पोलीस स्थानकाचेर केल्ल्या हल्ल्या वेळार बाळा राय मापाली हांकां पोर्तुगीजांनी अटक केली. तांचे कडल्यान भौतीक माहिती मेळोवच्या खातीर तांचेर बनखणीत भयंकर अत्याचार केले. मात तांणी तोंड उगडले ना. तांकां जाल्ल्या गंभीर जखमांक लागून 15 फेब्रुवारी 1955 दिसा तांकां मरण आयलें. गोंयचो मुक्ती संग्राम आतां गती घेतालो. पोर्तुगीजांनी स्वातंत्र्य सैनिकांक धरून काळख्या बनखणीक घालप सुरू केले. त्या राजकीय कैद्यांक आग्वाद किल्लो ते अंगोला आणि हेर पोर्तुगाली वसाहतीक बनखणीक घाले. खुबशे स्वातंत्र्य सैनिक ह्या काळख्या बनखणींतल्यान केन्नाच परत आयले. सत्याग्रह झालो आणि पुराय दीस किल्ल्याचेर तिरंग उभारलो. हो किल्लो मुक्तीचे प्रतीक झालो. हो किल्लो स्वातंत्र्य सैनिकांचे शौर्य आणि बलिदानाची भांगराळी याद करून दिता. 1955 वर्षा देशातल्या हेर राज्यांतल्यानय गोयच्या मुक्तीची मागणी वाढपाक लागली. 1955 वर्षा गोंय विमोचन समिती घडयली. जगन्नाथ राव जोशी, मधू दंडवते, मनू दिमये, कर्नल सिंग बेनीपाल सहित हजारोनी सत्याग्रहींनी वेगवेगळ्या ठिकाणच्यान गोंयात भितर सरपाचो यत्न केलो. पोर्तुगीज सरकारान सत्याग्रहींचे फारपेट केलो. तातूंत 20 सत्याग्रही मरण आयले. स्वातंत्र्या उपरांत भारत सरकाराचे पोर्तुगीजां वांगडा उलोवणी करून शांतीपूर्ण उपाय काढपाचे यत्न चालू आशिले. मात हे यत्न फळादीत झाले. भारत सरकारान लष्करी कारवाय करची पडली आणि मागीर सुरू झालं ऑपरेशन विजय. भारतीय सैन्यात 18 डिसेंबर 1961 दिसा गोयची वाट धरली आणि कांय वरां भितर पोर्तुगीजांक आत्मसमर्पण करचे पडले. आझाद मैदानार पोर्तुगालच्या निमण्या व्हायसरॉयान आत्मसमर्पणाच्या कबलातीचेर सही केली. पोर्तुगीजांच्या शेकातल्या मुक्त झाले आणि तिरंग बुबुळ स्वातंत्र्याच्या संघर्षाची ही कहाणी रक्तान भरलेल्या ज्या मुक्त स्वतंत्र हवे आम्ही श्वास घेतात त्या खातीर कितल्याशा स्वातंत्र्य सैनिकांनी सर्वोच्च बलिदान दिला व त्याग आमच्या काळजांत राखून दवरूंक जाय. गोय मुक्त जाऊन 60 वर्सां जाता आसतना दर एका गोंयकारान ह्या उत्सवात वाटेकार जावचे असो उलो गोंय राज्याचे मुख्यमंत्री डॉक्टर प्रमोद सावंत हांणी मारला. जय हिंद.
Perhaps he was on and off to our college as a speaker, but today is a special occasion for him to be over here. He has been selected as one of the great eminent speakers. Due to his contribution as an environmentalist, you might be knowing him, but he is also a good thinker, a writer in English, Hindi and Marathi also. So we have, you know, multi-talented, multi-dimensional person here with a good thought and a message for our young students, and that is he is going to give us to his deliberation on the topic Goa through ages. I hope that you all will have a benefit of his deliberations today, and I wish that my student will interact with him because he likes the interactions with the young ones. He always wants, you know, the youth to be better youth, and as I know him, like, he wanted that youth should be touched to the ground and earth, you know, that only we learn in this. So let our that source of inspiration be motivated to our own students, to their new habit, to their thinking habits, and for the good world to live in, for Goa as well as for our earth. So I welcome you, sir, on behalf of our Director of Education and Government of Goa. I welcome you for
this series of the series and inaugural of this country. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. I now request Dr. Reshma Kholkar to introduce today's chief guest, Sri Rajendra K. Devabare Guru, Dr. Lupa ma'am. भूमने श्री राजेंद्र पांडुरंग केरकर हे एक समर्पित पर्यावरण मोगी. तांकां 2011 ह्या वर्सा सेंचुरी ग्रीन टीचर्स अवॉर्डान सम्मानीत केल्यात. तांकां गोंयचे ग्रीन एम्बेसेडर म्हूण वळखतात. तांणी केल्ल्या सेवेची दखल घेवन तांकां राज्य, राष्ट्रीय आनी आंतरराष्ट्रीय पुरस्कारांनी सम्मानीत केल्यात. नॅशनल बोर्ड ऑफ वायल्डलायफ ऑफ इंडिया आनी स्टेट बोर्ड ऑफ वायल्डलायफ, Goa State Environment Protection Council, Worldwide Fund for Nature India हांगा काम करताना म्हादय आनी नेत्रावळीत वन्यजीव अभयारण्य म्हणून अधिसूचित करपान समविचारी व्यक्तिमत्वा बरोबर ताणी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका साकारली. गोंयचे रान पर्यावरण आनी पर्यावरणाचे संरक्षण करपा खातीर ते सदांच कार्यरत असतात. ताणी गोंयच्या वेगवेगळ्या आयामाचे मराठी ताणी गोंयच्या वेगवेगळ्या आयामाचेर मराठी आणि इंग्लिश भाषेतल्या असंख्य लेख आणि शोध निबंध सादर केल्यात. कोकणी तसेच इंग्लिश रिसाळ्यांनी लेखन करून सगळ्यो 11 नद्यो आणि त्यांच्या उपनद्यांचे रक्षण करपा खातीर जागृताय निर्माण करपाचे काम तळमळीन ताणी केला. ताणी भारत सरकारान स्थापन केल्ल्या पश्चिम घाट पर्यावरण तज्ञ पॅनला खातीर गोय आणि काणकोणातल्या खाण कामाचो सामाजिक आणि पर्यावरणीय परिणामाचे एक बरो संशोधनात्मक शोध निबंध बरेला. भोमानी श्री राजेंद्र सरांची ओळख चार उतरांनी पुराय करप हे एक खूप कठीण काम, पण आज आमच्या मदीं राजेंद्र केरकर सर वेळान वेळ काढून आयिल्ले आसात म्हण हांव तांकां मना काळजासून देव बरें करूं म्हणटा आणि ह्या कार्यावळीक तांकां परत एकदा योगदान दिता.
Now, without further ado, I request our chief guest, Sri Rajendra Kelkar, to deliver his talk.
Good morning to you all, respected principal of your college, Dr. Purnakala Saman ma'am, respected Dr. Asha Gelot madam, my classmate right from 11th standard, Dr. Prakash Budrik, all the dignitaries who are here. I'm very happy to present before you slideshow presentation on Goa through ages. So when we say Goa, you know, the Goa is a very small state. If you look at the Uttar Kannada district of Karnataka, or if you take the example of Sindhudurga in Maharashtra, Goa is not even 1/3 of the Sindhudurga. Sindhudurga is 8,000 plus square kilometer area, and the same story is of the Uttar Kannada. But in spite of that, you can see the people right from the prehistoric period till this date attracted towards this tiny land? What is the attraction? The climatic condition, the water, for what? Our well-known poet, Bakiba Borkar, in his Marathi poem says, Hirva anika pani tethe spurti madala gadi. You know, the land is blessed by the water, and the water, if is there, that will going to always help you to live. And that is why our forefather called water as the elixir of life. And the same story, if you look at Agwad, the port Agwad got the name Agwad. In Portuguese, Agua means water. So people right from the Kerala to Zanzibar, they were coming to this land and they were stationing their canoe in Agwad. So Goa whole attraction for the people right from prehistoric period. And my first slide takes you to Sattari Taluka. You know, Goa has 12 Taluka. Out of this 12 Taluka, Sange is the biggest taluka. 820 square kilometer is the total geographical area of Sange. Now you know the Sange is divided into two parts. One became Dharwadoda. Earlier also the Sange taluka was divided into two. One was Ashtagar and the second one was, you know, Himar Barshe. Himar Barshe got the name Himar Barshe because of once upon a time the Himar tribals were revealed in this area. So Sattari is the second biggest taluka of Goa, 490 square kilometer total area. And in Sattari, on the bank of the river, there is one deity. The name of the deity is Kebai. Locally, we call this deity as a Kebai. And shrines of Kebais were there in Goa before coming of the Shivaji in this land. And Mori documents of which are available regarding the temple of Kebai in Mai clearly throw lies on the aspect how Kebai is associated with the Goa. And Kebai, you know, is not only unique to Goa. If you go to Sanchi, there is Buddha's memorial is there, stupa is there. So backside, if you go, you will find the Gajalakshmi. And you know, the in Buddhism, the mother of Gautam Buddha is also worshipped in this form. If you go to Alampur in Andhra Pradesh, on the entrance you will find this Gajalakshmi deity. Or to go any part of the Maharashtra like Satara, Sangli or Karnataka, you will find this deity. However, this is very unique goddess in Goa because you find a representation of the state tree of Goa. Goa has two state tree. One is called Terminina elliptica, that is Matiche Zhad or Matula. And recently we got another coconut. So coconut representation is there on this tree, on this panel. And coconut, you know, is one of the important nut. And we have the description of coconut in, you know, Ibn Battuta, who visited India in 14th century. If you read the description as far as the Goa is concerned, you will find very interesting aspect about the coconut. So coconut, though, you know, we have the Narli Purnima, wherein we offer coconut to the ocean, to the sea. Coconut is not an indigenous thing. It came from the Pacific, the deepest, the biggest ocean of the world, to this land, and today, you know, it became the aspect of our religion, aspect of our culture. And this Gajalakshmi is very important because it depicts the jal, water, jungle, forest, and zameen, that is soil. Mati kahe kumar se, tu kyo rondhe mohi, ek din aisa aavega, mai rondhungi toh. So finally, the clay is supreme. You may be buried or burned. Finally, we become one with this soil, and this is the representation of the soil, how people were worshipping the soil in our land. And Gajalakshmi tells you about this thing. You say, see, it is the goddess of the prosperity, Samruddhi, and you can find the musical instrument. And that is why during the Kadamba period, Goa was not only the prosperous place, or you can see it is called as the golden era. Before that, the Goa also was a prosperous region. And that is why you will find this type of the panel in Goa. Arabian Sea, you know, is a wonder. And if you go to a place called Marma Goa, what you call, the actual name is Murgaon. Murgaon got the name Murgaon because of the Murum. You know, Murum is a very porous. When the rain falls, Goa gets, you know, 3,000 millimeters of the rainfall. So all this rainfall goes in the soil and we get the drinking water. So because of that, the Murum is there. Because of this Murum Gram, the place called the name Murgaon. So if you go to Murgaon, you can see one of the finest harbour of India, Marma Goa, for what you call Vasco, for what you know, because of the Sambhaji, the capital city was shifted right from Panjim to Marma Goa. So that is why it got the name Sambhaji Nagar also. So this place is very beautiful, and you can see this is the sea, 200 kilometers away, this bird is there. This bird is, you know, is called mask booby. Very beautiful bird, very rare, you cannot see in your locality. That is why I brought it. So, Arabian Sea plays very important role. Why? You know, we have the airport, and in spite of that airport, the government plan another airport at the Mopa. What is the reason? The reason behind, you know, Pakistan is very near to Goa. And from Karachi, you can come directly to Goa via this Arabian Sea. And that is why Indus Valley Civilization, we get the reference of the Magan. What does this Magan mean? Magan means the Oman. So from Oman, you can come directly to Goa. So Goa is connected, well connected. And because of this Arabian Sea, you can see the history, geography, everything changed of this small land. Next slide. 3.4 billion years ago. What was there in Goa? There was no Goa, there was no India. There were two things in the world. One is called Pangaea and Panthalassa. So afterward, you know, the drift began and, you know, many continents came into being. And this is the stone in Goa. If you go to Molem to Ramnagar, Nunda, you can see Anmol Ghat. In the Goa region, you will find this strontianumite gneiss. This strontianumite gneiss is existing in Goa when there was no Himalaya, when there was no Arabian Sea, when there was, you know, no country called India. So we have such type of the thing which make us very much proud. So this is the geological wonder, strontianumite gneiss stone. You can see in Anmol, and if you go to Kankun, Palole, for example, the beautiful and cleanest in once upon a time, the beach of Goa, there is one island called Kanko and Manko. So if you go to Kanko and Manko, you can see this strontianumite gneiss there also. And right to Patni also, you can see the wonder of the Goa. If you visit the butterfly beach, you know, very beautiful beach while going to Kap Dharampur, Kholgad. So here there was reference of the Shivaji, that Shivaji conquered areas like Bicholim, Pernem, and you know, Satari Taluka. But there was a rule of Shivaji Maharaj in Ponda Taluka, Kepe Taluka, Kankun also, got it, no? So, Samdekars were ruling over Goa, but they were not actual ruler. They had to pay respect to the Shivashai. And if you go to Mardangad, the clear indication is there. And if you go to Kepe Taluka, there is an area called Betul. So, there are letters, if you read the writing of S.S. Desai, Sasham Desai, his book on the Portuguese-Maratha relations. Two books are there in Goa. One is written by Dr. Pandurang Pisulekar, and another book is written by Dr. S.S. Desai. So both these books will enrich your knowledge about the Goa. So there are letters in that S.S. Desai's book which tells you about the Shivaji gave order to his Killedar of Bali to build a fort in Betul. Why Betul? Visit the Betul and then you will find a lot of exciting things. You know, we always tell the students about the history of the Goa starts with the Chandor or Chandrapur. My request to you, just go to the port of the Kabdaram and in the coconut grove, just dig the soil and you will find the huge bricks we got. These bricks, when compared to the size of the bricks found in Chandrapur, equal size bricks were there. We inquired the people about these bricks. They told us that once upon a time the Moru temple was there. Who was this Moru? Mallikarjun. You know, the Mallikarjun came to Goa via Srishailam. Visit Srishailam and you will find how tribal people are connected with the Srishailam. Srishailam also, you can see in southern India when you know Malik Kapoor, Alauddin Khilji's commander, when he demolished, he went to Warangal. Everywhere he burned, destroyed the temples. But in spite of that, afterward you will find the Muslim rulers also destroying. But in spite of that, a small area called Srishailam was protected by whom? Because of the inspiration given by Shivaji Maharaj, the tribal people guarded it. And you visit an area 1 month before the Mahashivaratri. You know, Goa also, if you want to see the Goa's connection with the Uttar Kannada or to the other areas, then the best place is walk along with the Mallikarjun in Signia, that is Tarangas, to Uttar Kannada. From where the Mallikarjun of Gavdongri, Sristhal and Kankol Sristhal going, that will the actual geographical area of Goa. So Mallikarjun temple remains were found in that area. That tells you about how, you know, history is very rich. And this stone tells you the history of 3.4 billion year period. Limestone caves are there. You know, people are running Andaman and Nicobar to the northeast part of India to see the limestone caves. In Goa, we have limestone caves, belgamite, tektite, all these are there. If you go to Sandri, you will find this limestone cave. And one of the limestone caves, we, you know, I used to read the writing of Anand Kinai Dhume, the cultural history of Goa. And he used to tell us the story in the book that, you know, Goa was under the water of the sea. The concrete evidence of this I am just putting before you. It is your responsibility, your geology, geography teacher, history teacher, to take you and finalize whether all this is limestone or not. I am an ordinary man, lay person, putting all this before you. Now, the field is open for you. This is limestone cave. If they are not limestone cave, then you can prove it. So this is inside, you know, area. You know, you will not believe that this area is in Goa. Hundreds of people phoning me and asking me, where is this place? There is a waterfall called Zhaotisovoda, where, you know, the water is available for the year. People are going there. But now, everything is prohibited because the tigers are there. So this is the limestone caves. And limestones are there in Goa, starting from Dhuripur till Vaigini. You get the reference in the Viti Guni book. And if you read the writings on the geology of Goa, Dr. Gokul and his teammates. So this is the limestone. When a small piece of limestone was fallen, I brought it and gave it to Dr. Manoj Ibrahimpurkar of Jambu College. And he confirmed that it is a limestone. So this is, you know, the stone, you know, named by the people of Sattari as Mama Bhachatu Guno. So this, I asked to the people, they were not ready to share the information and they told me, they took me to a same type of the structure in Kodal. I told them that Mama Bhajatupura is totally different. And finally, with the maps, we went and we got this area called Mama Bhajatupura. You can see this wonder are there. This is whole limestone and this is on the border of the Karnataka, but only in the Goa area. So this is the main rock which tells you the legacy of Goa. Next. सुशी से पहले सब नहीं था, असत भी नहीं था, अंतरिक्ष भी नहीं था, क्या छिपा था उस अगन अतल, जल भी कहा था. एंड वेन वाटर केम, यू नो, 140 मिलियन ईयर एगो, दिस फॉरेस्ट इज स्टिल, यू कैन सी इन माय सत्तरी एंड इन सांगे तालुका. इन सत्तरी देयर इज अ प्लेस कॉल्ड निरंकाराची राय. In Maloli, you will find this inverted type of root vegetation is there. This is called Meristica. Meristica, you know, is a zaipal. Most of the things which we are using in our day-to-day life comes from the wild. You know, there is one sacred grove on the 726 meter above the sea level on the hill of the Bagheri, which is called as Maulichi Rai. So in Maulichi Rai, you will find different type of the spices, and those students who want to understand the culinary heritage of Goa, you should visit this Maulichi Rai and how the people domesticated different types of the wild thing into their day-to-day life. You know, European came to India. We are told that they came to spread the Christianity. That was not the main reason. The Christianity was not born during those days. The European were coming to Goa, Amerigo Vespucci, Columbus, and then you know the Vasco da Gama in 1498 came to Kerala, Kazhikode or Calicut. What was the reason? The main reason was paper. The best of the paper of the world, Miri, you will find Dharatri Miri Ge. You can see in Dharo song. Miri in Shirshi. Meet Pandurang Hegde there and see his Kulagar. Hegde family originally from the Maharashtra went to Karnataka and enriched the Karnataka. And if you go to Shirshi, near to Banvasi, the old capital of the Kadamba, you will find so many things there. Yellapur is there. In Yellapur also you will find this type of the Meristica swamp vegetation. So in Goa, we have Netravali Valley, three places are there. Suyaka is there. Another place is Tarawri is there, and the third one is Paradar. These are the three places. And while going to the waterfall of Sauri waterfall, you can see specimen of this Meristica swamp. But the best swamp state in Goa is in Brahmakarmali, Azopachitoli and Vipyan. These are the two areas. And you know the how, why we require this type of the thing. You just go and drink the water there, nowhere. You will find such a tasty water. You know, people from various parts of India are coming to Kodal. For what reason? Taking huge barrel, early in the morning, they are standing there and filling the barrel and taking to Hyderabad and other part of India. Right from Kodal, the water is going to the various part of India. Why? People believe that water contains medicinal property. So go to Kodal and see. And Brahmakarmali has you know, very tasty water. So this is Meristica swamp vegetation, 140 million years old vegetation is there. And Bhu Gaonkar and Dr. Janardhanam, they have already written the paper. You can read paper also written by Dr. Mehta. I was I have done the post graduation in sociology and history, but they took me on their backside because my leg was fractured, and finally they repeated, and it is proved that this is 140 million year old vegetation. So there are very few areas. Go to Madagascar and you will find this vegetation has linkages with Madagascar. You know, Madagascar is not in Asia, not in Africa. It is drifted away from the Africa. So India was one with Africa. You know, the grass which is found in the African continent, also found in Kankhavli. And you know, the national flower of Zimbabwe is small rhizome. We are using it. Earlier people used to think that rhizome contains poison. So it has a medicinal property. So this Agnishikha, or the flame of the forest, is the national power of Zimbabwe. So it is there in Goa. You can see the wax substantive flowers are used for the matori. So it tells you how, you know, the land was won, and this Meristic Asam vegetation is very unique. Next. This is in Kunkolim. Right from Kunkolim, go to Bali, where you know the Patharpa area. On the way, you will find the origin of the river Sal. Sal originated actually in Verna, and from Verna the river goes, and one of the tributaries originates in this area as Pars. So there you will find the cave of Malangini. So Malangini caves, already research papers are published. If you read the writing of Dr. Nambi Rajan, you will find a lot of information, and he got the evidences of the prehistoric man inside his caves. So if you go to this place, you can see more than 100 people can be accommodated in this caves. This is Malangini, and we have many caves in Goa. For example, the Naroda village in Latambar, the biggest village of Bicholim Taluka, also houses one of the natural cave, but it is no more there. In Sattari Taluka, we have the Bab. It is also famous for the caves. So caves are very important. So this is the cave having the settlement of the prehistoric man. Next. So we, you know, we have the folk songs which tells us that Sata Khanda Prithvi, Sata Samundar, what it, no? So all this is told to us through the folk songs. So folk songs are invoked among the tribals, also among the non-tribals. And you know, this is, you know, the so many scholar call it as a Chakravyuh. So there are people who call it labyrinth. What is it? Puzzle is there. But this is, you know, the history of Goa. We start right from 10,000 years. The Mesolithic period. Before Mesolithic, there was a period called prehistory, Paleolithic period. And in between Paleolithic and Neolithic, there is a Mesolithic period. So during the Mesolithic period, you know, a river which was originating in the Nasa Dongar in Nunde, where the temple of Mahamaya is there, the river comes down, and in the river you will find on the bank of the Kushavati 100 rock carvings are there. One of the rock carvings of the peacock is there, then bisons are there, antelopes are there, and this is labyrinth like thing is there. I am not calling it labyrinth, but discussion is going on all these things. So this is the Mesolithic period rock carving, 10,000 years old, and right from this area, this is in Sange Taluka. The area is called Ponsoimar. So don't call it Uzgaimar. Uzgaimar is the part of the Kapen Taluka. Wrongly, it is identified as Uzgaimar. So in Uzgaimar, there is one more rock carving, and that is in the Pirla village. Uzgaimar is a part of the Pirla. There are two Pirla in Goa. So don't go to more Pirla. There is one Pirla called Sur Pirla. So now people, if you go and ask them about Sur Pilla, they will not say, they will call it as Kavre Pilla. It is in Kavre village. So on the bank of the river Kushavati, second rock carving site is there on the lake right, and the third rock carving site is on the granite. That is in the Kajur village. And next. This is in Mawshi. Mahavus, Sugarcane, what you know, Sakri the Katala Devdena. Now we have to change it. Satri is the Kanatala Dev Laukari Gamdada. So that is why you have to think about whether the bones were using the sugar cane or what. But you know, there is a surname called Shinde. There is a tree called Shinde in Goa. But you know, you get a Khazur. Chins, what you know. We have the reference of the Chins in the Muktabai song. Chinchicha Panavara Bandile Devula Adhikar Samadha Payari. And we have the word called Tamar Hind. In English, tamarind. tamarind, khajur of India. Actually, chintz or tamarind is not Indian. It came from other part and it became so much with the India, no? That we cannot think of the history without India. So, chintz is there. In Maushi, you will found this rock carving. Rock carvings from the Mata Basalt. And if you go today, you will not going to see this. This is under the soil, under the water. And you can see the two bulls are there. These are zebu. These were the animals which were in the prehistoric period. They were in the jungle. The human beings started domesticating them. And then during the Neolithic period, you know, the women's first were digging, using the digging sticks. Even if you go today in Man village of Swarla, you will find a woman digging the soil for the agriculture. So digging stick was used by the woman, and it was the history of the woman that gave us agriculture. And that is why we are now following the word called Sanskruti. That is because of the woman. So man folk was in the jungle doing the hunting during those days. So this is the indication of the duality period. And you can see the dancing dancer, you know, in Sindhu, Indus Valley civilization, you can find the dancer. And even in the rock art of the Maushi, you can find this dancer. Also in the Parsai Mall, you can see the dancer there. Next. Five thousand years ago, Dr. Subhash Chandra, the scholar of the Kumta College, written a paper on the Myristica swamp vegetation. In that, he takes the bird view of the shifting cultivation, the zoom cultivation in the, it is called in the northernest part of India, Kumeli cultivation, what you call. So how the people, without using the plow, doing the agriculture? These are the stone tools which were used by the human being, and in the rustic farm of the Rive, we got this stone weapons. The stone weapons also found in the Dudhsagar Valley. Dudhsagar River originates in the Kali Tiger Reserve in an area called Katla and Payana. Then the river joined together and tumbled down the water from, you know, the Kesal Rock in the village called Sonawal. And you can see the Khandepa River taking the birth. So in the Khandepa and also in the Ragado Basin, the stone tools were found in the area. Next. Badami Chalukyas were ruling over the Goa. So during those days, if you go to Vatapi, that is Badami, in Bagalkot, you can see it is the capital city of the Badami Chalukyas. So Badami Chalukyas, second capital city in Konkan, was ready. Revati Deep. So right from Revati Deep, they were ruling over Goa. And this is the cave. But you know, there are some scholars who says that these are the Buddhist cave. But Dr. K. Sundara written a very research paper and clearly gave us indication that these caves belong to the Shaivites. So the worshipper of the Shivas are there in Goa, and that is why you can find the Rudreshwar temple there in the area. A beautiful area, and this is, you know, the Badami, belonging to the Badami Chalukya period, more than 1400 year old caves in the lake, right? So today, you know, people call it as a Pandavancho Gauryo, but you know, Pandavas are not the historical figures. We have the epic called Ramayana and Mahabharata. So in that you find a reference of the Pandavas in Mahabharata. So Pandavas, whether they came to Goa or not, it is a debatable subject. But all this is the mythological figures. This is the temple. Just visit one area in Karnataka called Palasika. You know, Battle of Plassey fought in the year 1757. Why the Plassey got the name Plassey? Because of the Mutiya Manasparma. What is Mutiya Manasparma? Palash ke phool. The area is full with the palash, and that is why it got the name Palasika. Today it is called Harshi. So 10 temples of the same size of the same architecture you will find in this village. It was once upon a time the capital city of Goa, and we have the reference that Kadamba, you know, Goa was ruled by different dynasties: Abhir, Trakuta, Badpura, Kanchuri, Konkan Maurya, Badami Chalukya, Silaharas, the ruling over Goa. So this is belonging to the Kadamba period. This is the temple of the Mahadev, and I decided to find out where it connects the Tambisula, because I got the reference of the Ranichi Pass, and I started searching this Ranichi Pass. I went to Kanjur, I there got the evidences of the Kadamba specimen, and then I went to Kai Tiger Reserve, and inside the Kai Tiger Reserve, you get one village called, here is a Karanjol, and there you will find a Viranjol village. Both are connected. And then I asked where this road goes. They told me that this road goes to Tambisula. This is the Ranichi Pass. If you go to Viranjol, in Viranjol, from Viranjol you can go to the Tambisula. The area, the pathway used by the Queen Kamala Devi for coming to Goa was this. So this is the temple, you know, a poetry in the stone. There are people who say, no, this stone is brought from the Karnataka. You come with me, I will show you the area called Bhattar. And there is one huge stone. You will not believe that Telco company got the name from the stone from the Goa, my vision. Because there is one stone called Telco Guno. Telco Guno means you can sit on the stone and can see the glimpses of both Taluka, Dharbandura Taluka and the Sattari Taluka. That is called Telko Guno. Very huge monolithic stone is there. So from there, the stone is brought, and we have done the experiment because Suryakant Gavkar brought the stone and carved a beautiful stone panel of the Gajalakshmi. So this is the example how you can, the stone was used for building the temple, and this is on the bank of the Ragado River, which originates in the village of the Karambal in Karnataka, and then you can see the Vajrasakala. Then downward you can see the village called Keri. This is not my Keri village. There are 7 Keri villages in Goa. In Kannada language, Keri means water tank. So one more hamlet is there in Dharbandura, that is called Keri. And from Keri, if you come down, you reach in the Tambisula. So on the bank of the river, you will find this temple of Mahadev. And backside, you will find 50,000 year old memorial in the stone. God, you know, it has no connection with the temple. Temple history and the stone history are totally different. So this is one of the beautiful temple built by the Kadamba ruler Shivachitta Premadigal. This is not only one example. What you can do, you just go to the Peri of Toka, and from Toka go to Pegao, and from Pegao you will reach in a village called Hindoe. So in Hindoe village, what you know, Hindoe is today known as Narve, because there is no village of Narve in Vichulim Taluka earlier, because of Saptakoteshwar, the village got the name Narve. So in this Hindoe, you will find one huge temple like this, totally broken into pieces by the son of Aurangzeb. The Aurangzeb son came to Vichulim to nab Sambhaji Maharaj, because Sambhaji Maharaj, when he was a prince, Aurangzeb took him, misguided him, and kept him in his custody. So when after the death of the Shivaji in 1680, when he became the ruler, he took along with him the son of Aurangzeb, and he was there, Akbar II. So that is why Aurangzeb was very angry, so he wanted to capture Sambhaji Maharaj, and that is why he came to this area, and the many temples were demolished. We find a reference of the Ramchandra temple in Gimone, Pegao, converted into pieces by the son of Aurangzeb. So there also you will find the Jain court, the Jain temple was there, and you know the beautiful temple. We goes to Solapur to see the Siddheshwar temple. The same period Siddheshwar temple is there in Hindoe village, backside of the near to the Saptakoteshwar temple. Next. This is Jain heritage. The Jain temple in Kudne village. Kundanpur, Kaudinyapur, and if you go to Dhubasa Dam, you will find a memorial there. And you know, this village once upon a time full with the water only, and that is why it got the name Kudni, because of the Kunda, or I don't know. But everywhere you go, you will find the water. Before the onset of the mining, the village was full with the water. You know, almost 80 springs were there and containing the medicinal water. So this is the Gujirwada, and here you know the evidences of the Kadamba pyramids were found. So this is the Jain temple. How you know we came to the conclusion, because in the nearby well, the remains of the Tirthankar, the 23rd Tirthankar of Jainism, Pashvanath, were found. So this is the maintained today by archaeology and archives department of Goa. Next. So Surya temple is there, Sun temple is there, was there in Kudni. Many temples were there. You know, Goa was connected to the Ghat region by what? By the port of the Gandhi. From Busgaon, the river Mahadai is called as Mandovi. Because when the ships were coming from the distant land, they were paying the tax in Panjim. Panjim originally means Pandan Khalli. Creek was there, Pandan Khalli. In you will find a reference in Tribhuvan Mal inscription, Pandan Khalli. So this Pandan Khalli goes to the village of the Taligaon. There was no village called Panjim was there. You know, in 1843, the capital city was shifted from Ella to Panjim. So then only, you know, the Panjim became one of the finest capital city in the continent of the Asia. So this is the gate which tells you the history of the distant period. You know, the Siddhis people. Siddhis were originally from the place called Abyssinia. So Siddhi of Zanjira. Siddhis were there in Goa. And if you go to Ellapur, you will find the Siddhi there. And if you go to Ramghat in Tiwari, you will find the Siddhis there. So Siddhis are in three religions. They are Hindus, the present BJP MLA of Karnataka from Uttar Kannada region is a Siddhi, but he is Hindu. And you will find the Siddhis of Zanjira Muslim. And in Tiwari, you will find that they are also Catholic. So they divided into three religions. Actually, these were the people who are not believing in any religion. Our own culture start from the Ethiopia during olden time known as Abyssinia, and you find a Siddhi's reference in Sattari Taluka. So they were involved in trade, commerce, and this is the deity, Vijayalakshmi deity you have seen. This is Ashtabhuja deity sitting in the country canal. So this tells you that the river Mahadai, right from Ganje to Sattari, was navigable, and that is why this deity is worshipped in Sawade village, opposite to the Sonar village, and then also Virunda, and also in Dhamshe, we got almost 13 sculptures belonging to this period. So this is the Ashtabhuja deity. Next. We have the reference of 1526 Sri Krishna Charitra written by Krishnadas Sharma, and where he had written this Sri Krishna Charitra inside the Kardaliban. Where this Kardaliban was? The Kardaliban was in a area called Salset, in a village called Teosi, and it was afterward Portuguese divided the Salset into two parts. One became Marmagoa, and older became the Salset Taluka. So in Kiloshi, the Shanta Durga temple was there. So in 1526, the Sri Krishna Charitra, he started writing Sri Krishna Charitra. And after, you know, 40 years, the temple was demolished. And that is why the devotees took the deity and brought the deities in Kapilishwari, Kavale of Atruj Mahal, where you can see the temple of Goddess Shanta Durga. So only on the day of Diwali, after burning the effigy of Narakasura, if you go to the temple, you can see this pie, images of the deity. All gold. You know, this temple was looted 100 years ago by the Pathans. And this temple, you know, has a history, very interesting history there. Ram Madhav Rege, the minister of Shahu of Satara, donated the money and also land to the temple of the Santa Durga. Then, by reference of Bajirao first giving donation to the temple, this is the temple of Santa Durga of Kavare, a beautiful temple. This is the day of the Diwali. So, the Diwali is very interesting in Goa. It tells you the history of Goa. You know, the Goa Inquisition period, how it was harsh. You know, the temple of Lord Ganpati, which is there in your village, Kandola, was originally in the village of Naveli. You know, the Naveli was a part of the Diwali village. Diwali village. What do you know? So, Diwali was divided into, you know, there were two rivers. If you see the old record, you will find the island was divided into two, but 200 years ago it became one. So that is why you should read the book on the Diwar, of written by the principal secretary of PWB, Albuquerque. But you know, very big book published by Broadway that will give you insight in the history of the Diwar. And you should read the book in Marathi, Tandav, and in Kokani, Yugasavar by Mahabaleshwar Sai. It brings you to the notice how people were terrorized, suffered such humiliation. They ran away from Goa, went to Kerala, went to Maharashtra, and even today, you know, the best of the peoples of Goa, if you want to test, you will not find the best people except in Keri. And the subsistence, but best tuber if you want, go on the Wednesday market of Joyda, what you know, and there you will get the best tuber. Who took the tuber there? The Gowda community. The Gowda community, you know, today they are scheduled type, three scheduled type, but once upon a time they were one. And if you want to get a clear idea, you visit the area called Digi. In Digi, you find Gowda. In Digi will find Mirashi, in Digi will find Ved, in Digi will find Gavkar. All communities are there, but they belong to one stock, racial stock. So, history you can get. So this was the deity which was worshipped by different communities in Goa, and this is the Shanta Durga. This is the form of the Shanta Durga, goddess Shanta Durga. Next. Shivaji Maharaj, you know, what was the importance of the Shivaji Maharaj to Goa? The best example is the Portuguese poem written 100 years ago in Portuguese language, wherein the poet tells to Bhavani Mata, the Christian Sado, I say Sado because, you know, there was powerful struggle. In spite of going into Christianity, the two priests wrote two books. One supporting how, you know, the Saraswat are supreme in Goa, and another considering how the Chatva, the Kshatriyas are supreme. Both were converted to Christianity. So two books are there, and that is also you can read about the Surya Pan. If you want enrich your knowledge, you can read the book published by Directorate of Archaeology. The Goldsmith went to the various part of India, in Magan also, and I got the opportunity to meet a goldsmith there. So, Goa's goldsmith is very popular, and if you see the stories of Madhukar, goddess Navadurga, from where Navadurga is. Many stories are there. There is one story of the Gaushi. Sunil Gavaskar, the well-known cricketer, was originally from Goa. Family is originally from Goa. His deity was taken to Kadiyar. Then one more temple is there in Kundai, and you can see the Madhukar temple. So I went to the site of the Gaushi, all Gaus community. They are tribal. they are from this Gamshi area. So Navadurga's story is there. During the Datra days, the Navadurga deity stays in the house of the goldsmith. You know, the goldsmith made the ornament for the deity by looking at his own daughter. You know, after everything was completed, the daughter died away. Got it, no? And he looked to the deity at his daughter. How people were connected to the god. God is not a simple thing. These stories are there. So this is the Shivaji's. About Shivaji, the poem was written in Portuguese. He asked him to Bhavani Devi, why Shivaji is not taking birth in Goa? The Portuguese poem is there. And this is the topmost painting, world famous painting of Dinanath Dalal, Anant Nursiya Ka Dalal Knight, from the Kanpur. He went to Maharashtra and he, most of all the sketches in the book of the Bhamo Purandar, Baba Sahib Purandare, what is popular, Baba Sahib Purandare, all the sketches were of the Goan person, you know, his coronation ceremony of Shivaji, is very popular scene of Shivaji, given to us by Dinanath Dalal. And downward, you can see the temple of Saptakodeshwar, originally brought from the, there is a place called Narwa. So from Narvi, this Saptakodeshwar temple was there. It was demolished and some specimens were found. The temple of Kadamba period to the Grihastali Mittal Mandir. So in her research, this is, you can read it. So this is Saptakodeshwar temple, which was, you know, renovated by Shivaji in the November month in 1668. So you can find the reference in the stone inscription. In 1510, Apostol Bukhar conquered Goa, but he had to retreat. And you know, he was given assistant by some of the people, and that is why he came back again. And on 25th November 1510, he conquered the Kiswari. Not the whole of the Goa. So we cannot say that the Goa was ruled by Portuguese for 375 years. Only small area, small portion was there. That is called Tiswadiyari. Very few villages, island villages were there under the Portuguese. So slowly and steadily they increased their intensity. So the Apostol Bukhar was believing, he was a religious minded person. So he was believing that everything happening is because of the Saint Catherine of the Alexandria. And that is why he built the chapel there. In 1619, the chapel was converted into one of the beautiful World Heritage Sites recognized by UNESCO. And because of UNESCO, you are seeing this heritage. So this is Sikh Cathedral. Inside it, you will find 8 churches. So many enchanting things are there in Goa. For example, the patron saint of the ecology and environment, the ideology of Indian culture, you will find in the church of Augustine Tower is there. Almost 7 world heritage sites are there. So this is a beautiful, you know, it was the patriarch of the East Indies was residing there, was the chief there, and afterward he got the status of the Sikh cathedral. And famous historical site in the world. Next. The Islam, you know, came to India, and you can see a lot of changes. You know, in spite of burning, demolishing, you will find in the Hindu property of the Shetiye family, this Kirachadurga will be chosen on the bank of the river. Property belong to the Hindu, but the shrine belonging to the Muslim. And trees are protected. This is the example only in whole of India, as per my knowledge. Whether you will find in another place, you can bring it to my notice. But this is the mosque owned by the Hindu temple, Siddheshwar. If you look the Hindu temples and deities written by the Portuguese, you will find the temple whole area is owned by Siddheshwar, and in the Siddheshwar you will find this mosque. So on the day of culmination, the conclusion of the Shigmo festival, chala jau piracha bhete pira bhetla ardhya vate. So this song, folk song, you will find in this way. This is, you know, when Ghodamani of Pari means Peer A, who Peer come to my place. And you will find the reference of the Peer in the invocation of deity, and the Muzawar community, there they light the incense and the lamp in the honor of the Baba. And this is the only example of the Mughal architecture specimen in Goa. Nimuz Goa, built by Sambhaji Maharaj for his friend Akbar II. Varli painting, you know, is the popular art of Maharashtra, and in Goa there are people, scholar asking me about, was there any art? Yes, there was an art, and this is the Goa's art, Kavi art. This is called cow. Cow is available in Goa, and the best cow, if you want, go to Arvale. Got it, no? Natural mining set. So instead you will get a cow. So this cow was used by the Gawandi from Pernem Taluka to give us a beautiful architecture of the temples in Goa, which are standing for 300 years. Not a single example of the Kavi temple now is there in Goa. If you go to any place in Pernem or to any areas in other part of Goa, you will not find the Kavi temple existing. So only hope is there in Maharashtra, Zulambe. The Mauli temple is that it is fully in a Kavi art. So what is the Kavi art? If you want to know, then you can read the book of Rita Pandit, Grinding Stories Part 1, Grinding Stories Part 2. The preface is written by Damodar Mauzo, the Gyanpith Award winner for the book. So Grinding Stories, you will find most of the paintings, art, inspiration is taken from this. This is the original temple of Adwalpal of Maruti. Now the temple is preserved, but the chemical colors are used. Taking the inspiration from Karnataka, Marikamma temple, the department painted it in a chemical color without understanding. So that is why we raised, hue and cry, requested, go for the original color. The original colors were the natural dyes. And we mean our Suryakant Gaonkar, he gained success in preparing the color from the nature. So now if you go to Saptam in Narvik, you will find that the Kavi art in original form preservation is going on. Almost 41 forts were there in Goa, and this is one, you know, Rish Magush fort. This is, you know, the sketch given to us by Lopez Mendes 100 years ago. Few more slides of that. This is the beautification done by the Goa government. And here you will find the Mario Miranda's painting. This is the topmost portion of the fort. So this is one of the beautiful forts of Goa. And it is known as a prisoner, Madhulime, was kept in this fort. This is the fort of Nanus. You know, the it was told to us that the history of the revolt, actually the history of revolt start from 1575. The first revolt took place in the Punkolim, what you know, and then in 1583, and then you will find the reference of the Rane revolt, Dipaji Rana, Mahashura, Thuragad, this is, you know, the Nanus fort picture is there, and this is the Dipaji Rane painting. Actually, if you read the Dada Rane's chapter, it is very painful. A person from Dipaji Rane, and if you visit the Kumarkhand, there you will find his ancestral house. No remains you will find, but only memorial. There is no fort of Nanus is there in Goa. Only memorial, which was erected by the Portuguese, you can see on the bank of the river Mahare. So it was fort was conquered on 26 January 1852 by Dipaji Rane. I don't know whether you know this man. He was the Telo the Mashkarmis. He was born in Vasco da Gama, Gurgaon. He went to Portugal and translated to Indianize the Portuguese people about Amar Srushti Kavi Jathata Uthe Dhvani Amar Gane Sure Dagiye Kothani. Whole of Rabindranath writing poems, everything, including the Nobel winning 13, he got a Nobel Prize for Gitanjali. So all was translated into Portuguese by this man, Telugu the Mashkarnes. He was kept into prison. And when he was released, Goa got independence on 19 December 1961. And he was released from the jail in 1970. So many years he was in the jail. 1970. Telugu the Mashkarnes. She used to say, I am proud to be born where Ramayana. He was a scholar who studied Ramayana and Menezes Braganza, Luis Menezes Braganza from the Chando family of Chandor, scaled to such a height that he gained the name as the Tilak of Goa, the father of Goa's unrest. Next. Tristram Braganza Kunin, 1928, he was instrumental in establishing Goa National Congress, and Goa National Congress was the first forum where the people got opportunity to discuss regarding the Goa's sudden liberation, and you know, there were many people associated with this organization, and it was, you know, a patient of Dr. Julia Menezes. In Mumbai, both were friends, and Julia Menezes was used to appreciate Ram Manohar Lohia because he went to Nepal, and there he was instrumental in creating upheaval in the society of the Nepal. So when he returned back, he felt sick, and he was under the treatment of Julia Menezes. So during that period, he requested Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia to come to Goa for the rest, and he came to Goa on the 10th of the June in 1946. He was in Asolna, so people flocked to the place, and in Paris, Manohara Sardesai was there. How Zoe Beta Thay Atra June Gurjeta Agwa the Chashiva Mari Jumada Pirigata Takta Manpeta Ragat Kazanche Puttalai, the poem written by him in Paris. So, you know, Trivara Mangalavan, it was the day of Tuesday when, you know, the Goa's Revolution Day took place. He could not deliver the speech. He was arrested and was thrown at a Kulen station. But he once again came, but the incident was responsible for transforming the Goa. First martyr of Goa's liberation, Balaraya Mapari, born in a small hamlet of Moite in Asoda. Ordinary man, you know, he was the member of Azad Gomantak Dal, and many, you know, the teacher influenced him, and that is why Balaraya Mapari was in the liberation movement. And when, you know, the attack was done on the police station, outpost of the Asnura, the Portuguese suspected him, and he was taken into prison custody, and he was beaten badly, and it resulted in his death. Portuguese police were again and again asking him, tell us the name who were involved in the incident, but he remained silent, and he preferred that he died. You should read the stories of Bhagat Singh, Sukadev Raj during 1930. But you know, Goa did not get the freedom only because of the Tyagraha. We got the freedom because of the, right from 1575, struggle was there in Goa. Goan people unitedly fighting, and finally they were successful. And you cannot call this annexation of Goa by Indian army. Can you call? How you can call? Portuguese wanted to transform Goa into Portuguese India. And when You cross the I border, it was the British India. There were two countries, international border, were passing from Korean. So they want to create the two nations, but they did not achieve the success. So that is why we just read Zalta Bumantak and see how Portuguese made an attack. And even after going of the Portuguese, you will find the slogan of Viva Portugal. So read the writing of Pedro de Mascarenhas. Read them how denationalization of Cuba took place by all this writing of Luis Menezes Bragança in Prakash or Tibet or Tristram Bragança Cunha writing. So then you will understand and then you will never say Viva Portugal. So this is, you know, the place in a small hamlet called Patra Devi. On the border of the Adilabad. Adilabad is the modern Banda. It was known as Adilabad because at the Ramghat, this river was connected to the Arabian Sea, and the son of Aurangzeb used the ship going from Adilabad to Iran. So it was a navigable river. The river Terekhol originates in Manorgarh of the Sawantwadi Taluka, and then the river comes to Banda. It is called as Banda River, and finally it joins the Arabian Sea at Terekhol. So this is the place where you can see the Goan from various, the Indian from various part of India came. Pannalal Yadav from Madhya Pradesh came, Sohardara Devi, and Karnal Singh Banipal. Banipal is a small village in Punjab, very near to Pakistan. So from there, the Karnal Singh Banipal came and he died in Patra Devi. And from Parnir, at the age of 18, you can see a man came walking all the way to Lakhere of Borde in Bicholim Taluka. His poem, if you read, Deshata Samsar, Maji Angavari, Aisi, Ode Tari, Vatu Jabu Pratikasi, Madi Kasa Vitsari, Senapati Bapat, poem is there. He came and he was arrested in Lakhere. So Goa did not get the freedom. Gain the freedom by the struggle which was posed by various freedom fighters. So Patra Devi remembers us about his sacrifice. And Goa is very rich in the folk culture. Patama Namana Ganapati, Maga Namaya Sanskrit, Ramalika Pukrama, Sikh, it's about old history, culture, everything you will find in the Ramalika. And then filled and filled with the Muswanso, Fatlanso, Suti Sanso, Pilili Sanchi, Sandrachi, Yetu Basla Sahibin, Sandrachi, Or Shiva, Hariyaraya. The Sadhok Christian community, before starting of this pastoral dance, Shiva, Shiva Chandrishar Lord, that is why Musna Faith, who by Chanadi Sumarash. It takes you and visit. On the second day of the carnival, you can see this Musra Kheer in two areas, one in Sandur and second in Kauri. So, there are, you know, people who used to believe that there was a person, woman called Suranga Murugamkar. But actually, there was no Suranga Murugamkar. This was Anjali Bai Maltekar. You know, Goa. Name was made famous by Surasri Kesarbhai Kekar. Surasri title was given by Rabindranath Tagore and Anjali Bai Maltekar. We have series of singer, musicians who made the name of Goa very great, and that is why you will find musician singer in the Jalakshmi panel and all the architecture and sculpture heritage of Goa. So today, you know, we are facing the problem of agriculture. This is the silt-based agriculture, 5,000 years old, when the prehistoric man was in Purun Shedi. Now you will not see the Purun Shedi in Goa. This is the Vainodi Shedi. All this heritage is now on the verge of extinction. You know, people are now very much conscious about the health, and I was very happy to eat the sweet made from the finger mill, Nasne. Nasne came to India from Abyssinia, Ethiopia, and they are now so much one with this land that people cannot believe. You know, earlier I was given the sweet made from this finger millet. Now you are blessed by the multinational company. Sarah Luck, God, you know. But we, I can stand here because of the finger millet. So we are very blessed by this type of vegetation, different types of the vegetable. What type of the vegetable Goan people when we think Sakshi Rajabhane, Sati Steon is famous for? What you know? The Goan people are now, they are namesake, they are Goan. So if you want to be the Goan, then these are the vegetables which were used by the Goan in golden time. So this is Clarotrandum serratum. I don't know whether you have had it or not. Nobody is eating any leaves of the Via Indica, Vinachi Bhaji. No one wants to eat it. And if you want Bhaji, Pakoda, made from this Tamil Nadu Ulbinusa, there is a village called Peral in Sattari, famous for this pandre. So don't do experiment without asking me about the fruit. But you know, because Gare, the wild Goa is the same, look like the same. And you know, Tilaspora, Cardifolia, because of the SARS and because of the corona, people want this creeper. Got it, no? They cut the stem and mix the decoction, kodo, got it, no? But the leaves, they are not using. So you can cut the leaves and eat as a vegetable. So this is Tilaspora, Cardiopola. Cardiopola means good for the heart. Got it, no? So this was India's tradition. No one want to be Indian and no one wants to eat the Indian food. So this is, we are, you know, the follower of chili chicken, chicken 65. But you know, go and see how Goan people are blocking and all this. Wherever this is food. Tigers were not there in Goa. In 2002, government gave me a reply when I asked under RTI. Then I started my search for the tigers. I found the people in Dongurli. Dongurli was earlier the part of Sange Taluka, now it is the part of the Harbhanura Taluka. Dongurli in Thane, Dongurli there is in Pule, near to Pule. So this is the temple of the Vagdev, Vagro, Vagreshwar, and this is the tiger now in the jungle of the Mare. So it got the award in the Central Asia. We tried the same tiger in 2015. The tiger was tracked by Vijay Mohan Raj and the photo was put by him. And just recently I got the photo which I put in the newspaper. The study was made and the same tiger is there in our Mahare, jungle of the Mahare. So in 2020, four tigers were tragically poisoned and killed in Goa. And people were believing no tigers in Goa. So recently I proved that three tigers are there, two females and one tiger. And again, in another area, two more tigers are there. So tigers are there, tigers will be there. And as long as tigers are there in Goa, you will get the water. So minus tiger, no water. But you know, 43% of Goa's population get water because of one river, Mandavi River. There is no other river for it. If you take the case of the Zuwaari, it provides water to the one town called Margam and Coastal Belt area. And that is from the Saudi water reservoir and condition of the rest rivers of Goa. 12 rivers are there. 11 rivers, earlier 11 rivers were there. Recently I discovered one river. So I will put it after a few days that one more river is there in the village of your director Prasad Dolekar sir. The name of the river is Wakdi River. What do you know? So the Kesho temple is there in Dolie. So in front of that you can see this river is growing and finally joining the Arabian Sea. So tigers are very important. So if you protect tiger, you will get water, you will get oxygen. Otherwise, in corona, you have seen how we were struggling for oxygen. Artificial oxygen is the only solution. I don't know where we will take our generation. This is my river. I am struggling for it for the last 3 decades. And what is not there in the world you will find in this area. This is the Piscataway Coal. People are running to this area. This is the Bhimgarh Wildlife Sanctuary on the border of the Kadwar Lake in Sattari Taluka and Krishnapur, hamlet of the Keril Lake. You will find is statue. And these are Mahasir. These are the one. Mahasir means a big gear fish. Catfish in the state fish of the Goa. Show to what you call. In the same way, flame throated yellow bulbul, Busuddi, is our state bird. And now Goa government is in process of declaring the state butterflies of Goa. So these are Mahasir. Very beautiful fishes, but it's very tasty. But no one is allowed to fish in this area because there are, you know, the sacred groves where no trees should be uprooted, no vegetation should be cut. And there are water bodies in Goa where no one should do the fishing. No one should put the explosive like dynamite inside the water. So this is Impisati Pool, beautiful area. And this fish is the indication of the clean crystal water. In the whole of the world, these fish are threatened. They are put into the vulnerable threatened species list. So this is the story of the Mahasir. This is for my presentation, Goa through the ages. You know, I started the journey from the prehistoric period when no Himalaya was there. And in on 19 December 1961, we gained freedom. And today, the tricolor flag of India is unfurled in the sky. And I remember the poem written by Pandita Mahadev Verma, Aaj Tiranga, Vyakta Sunali Abhame. Isme har pehchan hamari, isme jaan hamari. इसके बंधन में झुककर ही उन्नत भाल हमारा। जय हिंद, जय भारत, जय गोवा।
I'm very sure, like me, all of you must have visualized the greatness of this land as sir was unfurling the opulence of Goa. Thank you so much, sir, for this insightful, enlightening and stimulating talk. Thank you so much once again. I now request our principal, Professor Kunkara Samant, to present a memento to sir. Any questions? Yeah. Any questions?
Our Vice Principal, Dr. Asha Kelly, to deliver the word. Namaskar. Param Adarani, Rajendra Jikhekar, College ke Pracharya, Professor Purakana Samant, Vajir Teacher Samri, Ani, विद्यार्थी नमस्कार. आज अर्थान आम्ही गोवा उत्सव मनयलो. गोय मुक्तीची 60 वर्षा मनयताना आज तुमका सगळ्यांकूच दिसले असतले की आम्ही खऱ्या अर्थान गोयचो उत्सव मनयतात. धरतीपुत्र राजेंद्रजी केरकर हांच्या बरोबरीन आज आम्ही गोयची युगकथा ऐकली. तांच्या बरोबर गोयचे दर्शन घेतले. न्हयेचे आणि कोणाचे कोण उदक पिले, माळा उदक पिली, फळाफळांची माहिती जाणून घेतली आणि युगपुरुषांबद्दल जाणून घेतले. सर उलयताना तांच्या वाणीतल्यान गोय आमकां स्पर्श करताले, गोय आम्ही जाणून घेताले, गोय अनुभवताले. हाजे खातीर एक व्रतस्थ जीवन जगचे पडटा भुरग्यांनो. आणि सर ते जगल्यात. ताणी ह्या गोयच्या धर्तरेचेर जीवा पहाड मोड केला. आणि या धर्तीक मग सुद्धा त्रासदायक झाल्या, त्याच्या जीवाची कासा विसरता तळमळ जाता आणि ही तळमळ आम्ही त्याच्या कार्यातल्यान पळेल्या. आई जेव्हा ते वाघ म्हणतात त्यांना फक्त वाघ नसतात, आई जेव्हा ते न्हय म्हणतात त्यांना ते फक्त न्हय नसतात. या सगळ्यात त्यांचं जीव असा, त्यांच्यानी जीव ओपला आणि म्हणूनच आज त्यांच्या बरोबर गोळीची भोवणी करताना सर आमका खूप 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 बरं दिसले. आम्ही संतुष्ट झाले आणि माझी बरोबर माझी आमची कॉलेजची फक्त 100 भुरगींनी तर युट्यूबार आणि त्याचबरोबर गुगल मीटाचेर बी भुरगीं आज तुमचे तुमकां आयकतालीं, तुमकां अणभवतालीं. सर मना काळजांतल्यान डायरेक्टर हायर एज्युकेशन आणि त्याचबरोबर आमच्या सगळ्या भुरग्यांच्या वतीन, आमच्या प्रिन्सिपलाच्या वतीन, आमच्या फॅकल्टीच्या वतीन तुमकां नमन करता, तुमचे अभिनंदन करता, तुमकां देव बरें करूं म्हणटा आणि असो आनंद सदांच आमच्या बरोबर आसतो. आमच्या भुरग्यां बरोबर गोंयच्या भुरग्यांची तुम्ही प्रेरणा आसात, पण आज फक्त 2 हात न्ही, हे 100 हात न्ही, तर खुबशे हात तुमकां लाभचे आणि गोंयच्या पर्यावरणाची जसे तुम्ही म्हणतात तसे संवर्धन जावचे, रक्षण जावचे असे म्हाकाय मनापासून दिसता. आणि आज ह्या भुरग्यांनी ज्यांनी ऐकला तातूंतली काय भुरगीं सुद्धा तुमच्या बरोबर तयार झाली जाल्यार आयचो हो दीस आणि सार्थक जातलो. आणि खरंच म्हाका आयचो दीस भांगरावळ दीस दिसता. सर मला काळजातल्यान देव बरे करू, देव बरे करू म्हणटा की आयज फक्त सरांक तुम्ही ऐकले हांगा, पूण संपूर्ण गोव्यातली कितल्याशाच कॉलेजीनी ह्याच वेळार कितलीशीच भुरगीं गोंयचेर आयज आपल्या धर्तरी बद्दल खूप कितें जाणून घेतात, खूप कितें ऐकून घेतात. आणि ही कल्पना ज्यांना सुचली आणि ह्या कल्पनेसून ज्यांना हे अशी अफलातून अद्भुत कल्पना म्हाका दिसता की गोंयच्या तरणाट्यांक ज्यांच्या हातीन गोंयचेच भविष्य आणि देशाचे भविष्य असा, त्यांना आपल्या माती बद्दल जाणून घेऊचो पुराय अधिकार असा, त्यांना जाणून घेऊक जाय आणि त्यांनाच त्यांच्या बद्दल सरा भशेन तळमळ निर्माण जातली. आणि ही कल्पना आयोजनच करू ना, नियोजनच करू ना, तर त्यांचे यशस्वी असे आज आयोजन केला आणि तीच कॉलेजीतल्या गोव्याच्या कोणा कोणत्या कोणत्या कॉलेजीनी तुमच्या भशेन कितलेशेच तरणाटे आयज गोव्या बद्दल ऐकून घेता. आणि ही आयोजन केल्या बद्दल डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ हायर एज्युकेशन डायरेक्टर श्री प्रसाद लोणेकर, त्यांची पुराय टीम आणि त्याचबरोबर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन आणि पब्लिसिटी यांचे आम्ही खूप 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 उपकारी असतात. देव बरे करू. त्याचबरोबर कॉलेजचे प्रिन्सिपल प्रोफेसर पूर्णकरा सामंत हे सदा भाषणच सक्रिय आणि उत्साहान ही कार्यावळ यशस्वी जावची म्हणून आमच्या बरोबर वावरली. मॅडम सदा भाषण तुमकां चढान चढ देव बरे करू म्हणटा, देव बरे करू म्हणटा. आयज कॉलेजीची सृजन मंचची टीम आणि ही कार्यावळ यशस्वी जावची म्हणून मेहनत घेतली. लोकमुद्रा रेशमा आसावरी विष्णू डॉक्टर डे मार्गदर्शक म्हणून आदितीचे नाव हा मुद्दाम घेऊ शकता की सर हा व्याख्याते आणि ते तटस्थ थंय उभे आशिले की केवळ आयजच न्ही तर काल पासून ताणे ती लाईव्ह स्ट्रीमिंग जावची म्हणून मेहनत घेतली. आम्ही आदिती खातीर बी ताळी मारल्या. डॉक्टर डे आमचे मार्गदर्शक म्हणून आशिले, प्रोफेसर प्रकाश वद्रीकरान आमकां ऐकले, रंजना म्हणून आसा, खूप जणांचे प्रोफेसर रथ हांगासर आशिले, अशे कितलेशेच फॅकल्टीज हांगा आमच्या बरोबर राहून ताणें ऐकले आणि तुम्ही सगळ्यांनी या सुवर्ण संधीचो लाभ घेतलो म्हणून विद्यार्थिनी विद्यार्थ्यांनो तुमकाय बी मना काळजांतल्यान तुमचे देव बरे करू म्हणटा आणि तुमच्या खातीर बी ताळी मारता. देव बरे करू म्हणटा ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव्ह स्टाफ आमचो जो सदांच आमच्या बरोबर असता आणि त्याचबरोबर आमची सगळी टिचिंग फॅकल्टी तांकां तर हांव देव बरे करू म्हणटा. आमचे वायस प्रिन्सिपल प्रवीणा केरकर, सीताराम सुकणकर आणि त्याचबरोबर सगळी टिचिंग फॅकल्टी आणि आमचो ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव्ह स्टाफ आमकांय बी आम्ही देव बरे करू म्हणटा. आणि त्याचबरोबर आमची मल्टी टास्क फॅकल्टी जर नसत तर असे आयोजन यशस्वी जावना, सो तांकांय बी आम्ही मना काळजांतल्यान देव बरे करू म्हणतात. सर अजून एकदा
students, as you all go out of the hall, refreshments will be served for you all, so you can take it one at a time, okay? So don't gather. So let's all stand for the national anthem.
विनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्रविड उत्तर गंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा चल जल तरंग शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभाशिष मागे गाए तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय हे
जय गोमंतक जय भारत।